It turns out that even Republican voters don't like Republican policies because Republican policies are downright awful. When they exist, of course. For the most part, the Republican Party in the United States has no actual plans. You know, as Trump admitted during the presidential debate, they have concepts of a plan, but they don't have any real ideas on what to do. So Data for Progress decided to do a new survey on the things that Republicans have kind of proposed, basically their concepts of a healthcare plan. And it turns out that an overwhelming number of Republican voters, a vast majority of them, reject nearly every single thing that Republicans want to do to healthcare. So here it is. Allowing insurers to deny coverage or charge people more if they have pre-existing conditions. That is something that Republicans have suggested, and it is rejected by more than 60% of voters, including Republicans, a majority of Republicans. Stopping Medicare from having the ability to negotiate lower drug prices. Well, 57% of the general public rejects that, and a majority of Republicans reject it. Allowing health insurance company to charge higher premiums to individuals who let their health coverage lapse. 49%, a plurality, reject that, and a plurality of Republican voters reject it as well. The list goes on and on. Decreasing funding for public health care programs. Plurality don't like that, and a plurality of Republicans don't like that. They do want the government, believe it or not, to actually pay for some health care programs. The point is this. Even the people who go to the voting booth every year, every 2 years, and vote Republican down the line, they look at the policies of these people and say, man, that sucks. Boy, I hate this. These people I am, you know, filling in the arrow for, they are just god awful, but I'm doing it. Why? Because that's how tribal you are? Because that's what you think you should be doing because you just hate Democrats that much? You don't even like your own party. And you're still putting these people back into power every time you go to the voting booth. The polls prove you don't like these ideas. You don't like Donald Trump's tax plan. You don't like his tariffs. You don't like your own party's trickle-down economics anymore, according to the polls. What you do like, when there's no political party attached to it, are things like a government-run healthcare system where you have no cost at point of service. You like the idea of saving the environment. Polls show that when there are not political parties or politicians tied to ideas, the majority of the country is super progressive. But once you start attaching political parties to it, these Republicans say, oh, hell no. No. I may not like what my party's doing, but I don't want these things that I liked a second ago because now I know they're Democrat plans. It's stupid. We're a country of morons. Like, we just are generally, when you put us all together, we're all dumb. But here's the kicker. It's not just Republican voters that don't like Republican policies, because apparently there are some very high-profile Republican lawmakers that are also speaking out against their party's own policies. And that happens to be coming from none other than Mitch frickin' McConnell himself. Earlier this week, when Donald Trump proposed putting a 200% tariff on John Deere tractors, Mitch McConnell came out and said this. Former President Trump has proposed a 200% tariff on John Deere tractors if they're made in Mexico. This was the question he was asked. Are you concerned that some of these tariff proposals by the GOP nominee could drive up costs for consumers or hurt bourbon exporters in Kentucky, for example? And McConnell said, yeah, I'm not a fan of tariffs. They raise prices for American consumers. I'm more of a free trade kind of Republican that remembers how many jobs are created by the exports that we engage in. And so I'm not a tariff fan. But Donald Trump's economic plan is 100% just do some tariffs. So your own party rejects Republican Party policies. Your own party elected leaders are rejecting Republican policies. So I don't know what more the rest of the country needs to reject Republican policies, but when they can't even convince their own voters and their own elected officials that their policies are good, then that should be a sign to you that these Republicans, today's modern Republican Party, has no flippin' clue how to govern. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.